Hey, horse people. I was watching this movie and just paying attention to the horses, and it's kind of funny. In a lot of these movies, even though they're making them like they're in the cowboy days, they don't have a lot of good horseback riders or horsemen in Hollywood. So a lot of actors have to learn how to ride a horse just for one little scene. And watching movies sometimes is hard. So I want you to watch this little horse gallop up this hill. You'll notice in a lot of movies, horses tend to run up a hill. And the reason for that is when a horse is cantering up a hill, it slows down the horse. The horse can only go so fast, and it's pretty easy to sit in a saddle when a horse is going up a slight hill. If you get a horse on a straightaway, he can get away from you, he can run, you can lose your balance because he's going to be going faster than if he's going up a hill. So if you notice, pay attention to a lot of horse movies. You'll see the horse always runs off uphill in a lot of scenes. See this scene right here? Horse running up the hill? Much easier for the guy to ride. And we'll go back to that so you can see that again. Up the hill. Much easier to sit. Horse is controlled by the terrain versus the rider. Now in this video, man, I'm getting a lot of lag here. I want you to watch this horse. This horse right here, they tried to cover it up, but he throws a little bucking fit right here as he runs off camera. So as he's running straight, he's going to come in over here on the right side. They'll go straight across, and I'm going to try to track him with this. But you'll watch right here at the end, watch this little guy. He's having a little fit because the rider's either bouncing or pulling on his head. So he starts trying to buck and run. I call this a buddy buck because when buddy bucks, he bucks about like this horse sometime. So let's watch this. Okay, so here they come. Remember, watch the second horse. Here we go. I don't know if you can see that. I'll try to do it again. Right here, buck, 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 buck. Right, one more time, and I'm just gonna leave it to where he bucks over here. And I'm gonna try and pause it. Ah, too late. He got out. All right, so anyway, just watching, remember when you're watching these videos. And it shows people riding horses. I'm always looking at their rein control and how they're holding their hands and where the horse's head, whether the horse is fighting them, etc. So these little guys are just walking along pretty good. Kind of loose reins. Another thing that you want to watch when you're watching these guys riding in a lot of your horse movies. See, this guy's hands are down low in that little box I talk about. You'll notice in a lot of Western movies, the hands will be up by the belly or up by the chest, and the rider will be leaning back, holding the horse because they don't understand rein control by keeping their hands low on the reins. They don't have to move their hands that high. So you'll see this hand right here come up higher a lot in a lot of videos. Just a couple things I noticed in this movie. Pretty good movie, and we'll end that there on developing that critical eye when people are riding horses and where their ears are at and how they're sitting and are they centered and are their toes pointed to the ground, are their heels low, or are they leaning forward, is their hand low and in a good close to the horn small 10-inch box. Okay, those are things to work on so you know what you're doing too. I forgot there was another scene I saw in this movie that I wrote down the time. I wanted to go back to it. When this woman approaches this horse in the scene, she just finds out her husband's dead. So she runs over to her husband who's supposedly dead. Well, the guy holding the horse didn't lean the horse's head a little bit to the left, would have stopped this maybe or distracted the horse. But she runs straight into this horse and spooks the horse. Almost the horse rears and runs away, and this guy uses a pain bit, has a very large bit. They all have very large bits on, and controls the horse. But She kind of screwed it up. They should have had her approach at an angle or the horse turned sideways. And had she approached at an angle, this horse would not give this reaction it's about to give. See that reaction? Let's watch that again. She runs up, the horse is calm, the guy's holding it. She runs right at his head, scares the horse. Ah! Horse almost jumps and runs back, and he pulls him in. Again, this was her error, not the horse. This was a setup error. They should have had her approach to the side. She runs right into the face, scares the horse, doesn't realize what she's doing. And again, people aren't used to working around horses. Who's ever their turner, or, who's ever set up the scene, isn't probably a great horse guy. He just works Hollywood. And he's used to probably a bunch of push button horses. He's probably running around. That stupid horse. He should have stood still. I'm not using him again. It wasn't the horse, you big dummy. It was the stupid human. All right, we'll end that there.